You are watching Cult Fusion.
In this video, we'll take a look at the latest information about the upcoming Samsung Galaxy Note 4. But first, some context. Over the years, many companies have tried to give birth to fresh ideas for consumer market goods. But a lot of the time, they ultimately fail in their goal. The Samsung Galaxy Note series is a rare success story in terms of a company going out there and trying something a little bit different. It all started with the original Note. It was bold at the time, considering the state of the art in 2011. A 5.3 inch screen when 4.5 inches was considered way too big, including a stylus when they were actually just on the way out. Real multitasking when the mobile operating systems were still in their infancy. But today, the climate is slowly changing. The Note series is not alone anymore in the tablet phone world. For example, the LG G3 is a compelling alternative with floating multi-screen features and hardware navigational features of LG's own invention. The Note series has always led the way in terms of specs and has always been future-proof. And as you're about to see in this video, it doesn't look like much is going to change this time around. Let's dive straight into the details of what the Note 4 is shaping up to be. Let's start with the build and materials. A lot of us would like to think that a premium soft-touch finish or a tasteful metallic flair will come to the Galaxy Note series this time around, but realistically it's most probably going to be plastic. Plastic is durable, but not everyone's cup of tea. I'm just hoping that there's no dimpled back here. Most current signs, such as the Galaxy S5, strongly hint that the Note 4 will be water resistant and dust proof. Alright, so let's move on to the screen. Although the trend in screen size for the Note series tend to increase by 0.2 of an inch every year, Samsung may not want to increase the size of the device this time around. If you look at the Note 3 right now, they can't physically add that much real estate without increasing the size of the device again. Korea Times are stating that there's going to be a curved version of the Note 4. I'd say it's probably going to be a spin-off well after the initial release. GSM Arena reports that the Galaxy Note 4 will come with a 5.7 inch, 2560 by 1440 resolution, 515 ppi display, putting it right in line with the LG G3. And once again, it's most probably going to be AMOLED. Although such a screen is awesome and will no doubt look incredible, I personally see such a resolution as a bit of a waste without any form of video output to a larger screen. It's really going to just be a major tax on the GPU during gaming and other drawing and rendering applications. But it's not all bad news though, because we're going to have a lot more power in the Note 4. Let's move on to that. So the engine behind this digital machine will probably be the Exynos 5433 and the Snapdragon 805 for some regions. The regions that get the Snapdragon 805 would be pretty happy with that. The 805 is a new generation from the Snapdragon 800 and 801 because the CPUs are now made up of Crate 450 cores instead of 400s. And the GPU is now the mighty Adreno 420, which is 40% more powerful than the Adreno 330 found in most current flagship phones.
Cool feature. So it's a completely brand new architecture based on DirectX 11.2. So it does support things like geometry shaders and hardware tessellation. Tessellation factor all the way. And you can see how GPU has dynamically added these triangles. You can have now crevasses within the crevasse effect within the ground itself. You can see more details on the back of the Hornet. So all that is possible because of the tessellation. And since the GPU is adding all these triangles on the fly and they're not loaded from memory or generated by CPU, that's a significant power saving. So Snapdragon 805 and the Adreno 420 GPU is built to do all the console quality graphics that the highest end PCs and consoles can do, but in a much, much efficient manner, because you're going to be saving a lot of power from bandwidth and not using CPU.
Samsung's marketing vice president told CNET that Samsung is very actively working on a 64-bit processor. So I'm not sure if this is going to make it into the Note 4, but it'll be cool if it is. But all in all, the 805 processor particularly is one to be excited for. It's an absolute beast. In addition to that processor, there possibly could be 4GB of RAM, but it's not unlikely that it could remain at 3. Moving on to the camera, both the sources Sam Mobile and AnTuTu say that it's going to be a 16-megapixel Sony IMX230 with optical image stabilization. The front-facing camera looks like it's going to be a 3.68-megapixel shooter. As for the battery of the Note 3, there's not much information on this yet, but I'd assume it will be around the 3,500mAh mark to balance out the power usage of the hungrier screen. And if it is that, it could actually end up lasting a bit longer due to the more efficient Snapdragon 805. There's also not much information on the software, but it'll probably be the latest version of Android directly after the Google I/O announcement, with a skin similar to that on the Galaxy S5 included on top. Rounding up the details in the Note 4, we're most likely going to see some S Pen improvements, of course, but there's no information of what those could be. It would be kind of cool to see some other features, such as front-facing speakers, but that's probably something Samsung's not going to just throw at us. So once again, I'm going to ask you guys, would you guys be happy with the Note 4 if it ended up being all of these specs? Let me know in the comments section below. Anyway, that rounds out this quick video, so thanks for watching, and don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you liked it, rate, comment, and subscribe. And if you haven't, check out the previous video, which is going to be the first link in the description, if you're interested in a bit of technology history. It's a pretty interesting video, so check it out if you want to see some more stuff. Anyway, I'll see you guys soon for the next video. Have a good one, guys. Again, in the previous decade. The story begins in 1974 with a young engineer working at Kodak. His name was Steve Sassen. One day, Steve's boss gave him a new kind of chip and a camera and asked him to do something with the both of them. It was really just to keep Steve busy at the time. The chip that was handed to Steve was a CCD.
Cold Fusion. It's new thinking.